It's time to do a deep dive with one of the new features of the Seestar, which is the planning mode, the scheduling mode, where you can schedule your own nights, plan your night. Now, to start this off, we're going to click on plan. And we're going to create a plan. We're going to label this YouTube just for the purposes of demonstration. And we're going to find the objects that we want to add. Now, remember that the whole point of this is to pretty much leave your Seestar outside, leave it there running all night, however many hours you want, and pretty much forget about it. And right now we're going to just do it to see how this works in action. Hey, just want to briefly mention, come join my Discord. While you're there, share your astro images with me and the rest of the Astro Room community. And if you'd like, you can watch or live stream your Seestar and even check out what others are live imaging in real time. That's right, simultaneous Seestar live streams. Come be the very first ones to try it. Let's build the biggest online star party together. And you can join the Discord by clicking on the link in the description below, and I'll see you there. Can't wait to see what you're imaging. So let's say we want to capture M42. We click on add there at the bottom. And you notice you can only start your sessions at 1900 hours, or in other words, 7 p.m. I am hoping that ZWO, the makers of the Seestar, will change this. I'm sure they will eventually, but we should be able to start these sessions earlier than that, because sometimes, as we know, it gets dark like at 6 p.m., 5:30 p.m., right? So for now, we're gonna go ahead and do this at the earliest that we can, which is already here, 1930 or so, so 7:30-ish. So let's go ahead and run it from 1940 to 1950, all right? So we're just gonna run it for 10 minutes. We know that we can run this for way longer than that, but you know, you can run this for as many hours as you need, right? But we're just gonna run this for 10 minutes. And it's cool that as soon as I went to this nebula, Orion, right, we're doing N42, it immediately put it on here, the LP filter. It turned on by itself. So once we know we want this target for however long, we're going to click on the check mark. Then we can keep adding other objects by clicking on object, and let's go ahead and get Horsehead Nebula. We're going to click on add, and we want that to start right after it's done with Orion. So another 10 minutes, we'll do 1950 to 2000. We're gonna click on the check mark, and let's choose another object. Let's do, why not Rosette Nebula? Let's do that one. Click on add. So you can see you can add as many targets as you need. At least that's what I'm seeing from the looks of it. We're gonna do each one of them for 10 minutes. However, I do see that Rosette Nebula is not quite centered there. I'm gonna delete that and redo it because I want it to grab it here. Now, do know that you can obviously do mosaic framing for all of these, but as we know, if I do that, it's just gonna increase the duration of shooting to a bit more. So because we're just doing a quick video, we're gonna not use mosaic, but you can feel free to do mosaic on any of these, and just know it'll increase your time of how long you're doing the image shooting, right? So let's do that for Rosette. Now it needs the LP filter on. I wonder, because I started messing with it, if it took it off. There we go. So I was able to put the LP filter. Oh, that was easy. I didn't have to delete it. Now let's start this. Let's execute the plan. And now you see how it says ongoing. So it should be going to my first object, which will be the Orion Nebula. And you see the plan now here. It's green, this little flash arrow there. Let's go to the Sky Atlas. Yep. Now, something you want to keep in mind as you're doing these scheduled sessions, you definitely want to do it for longer than 10 minutes on each object. And because remember that even though, oh, looks like it found Orion. Even though you might be putting, let's say, 10 minutes, 30 minutes, 45 minutes, or an hour on each object, you will most likely have discarded images for the most part, right? Unless you're already doing equatorial mode and you have way less discarded frames or no discarded frames. Ooh, yes. All right, got M42. This is exciting. So, wow, this was great. This was great. So now, once you finish that session, right, once the Seestar is done with that one 10-minute session or 30 minutes of an object, once you look at your final image, it probably won't say it was a full 10 minutes of image stacking or however long that you put it because of the discarded frame. So, you know, the longer, of course, you have it, the better your image. So you want to keep that in mind that, and we'll prove that right now, even though I put 10 minutes for this particular object, it might only be maybe 2 minutes, 5 minutes, or 8 minutes at the end of image stacking. So let's see how this goes. Now, because I took so long to start it, it was supposed to start earlier, but I took some time, so it's not going to even be the full 10 minutes. I started it, we only have about 5 minutes left of image stacking. And yeah, so let's see how this goes. There it is. It's still ongoing. Yep. And kind of neat, you can stop it if you don't like it anymore. But remember, this is all supposed to be happening while we're not even paying attention to it. So I'm wondering now if I can create another plan while I have this one in process. Like, could I create another one? Let's try it. Test number 2. No way. So I guess it will. Let's say I want this same image, but I want it later in the night. Well, before it leaves my view. This is interesting. I guess it will. We're just gonna pretend. Andromeda. Let's add it. This is very interesting. Might not be able to get this in that field of view because it's going to be gone. I guess it's letting me now. Okay. Let's just do those two targets because I'm in shock. Now, if I click on execute now, I wonder if it'll kind of put it in order for it to be ready to go later. Okay, so it's telling me operation not allowed because an ongoing plan is in progress. Please stop the plan first. Okay, now this is something that if ZWO watches this, I recommend for them to totally upgrade. And that's because it should know that it's at a way different time from the one I have right now, that it could just automatically switch to my next one. Now, ideally, I guess what you could do is keep adding, right? Keep adding more objects here. But what if you just forget or don't realize that you want more later? Now, looks like it's still doing M42. Should be switching to the next object soon. But if we open this, this is cool, right? It's telling me the planned targets for the night. It's currently observing this for this long. The next one to observe Horsehead Nebula and then the Rosette Nebula. So this is pretty neat. I can go gazing. So it'll show me what it's doing right now. This is great. Okay, so now it automatically stopped right at the time that it should stop, 1950, which is 7:50 p.m. here. And Yeah, 7:50 p.m. It went straight to the next target. So I'm assuming that the Seestar right now is slewing. It's slewing to the next target. Okay. It's definitely going there. Now, what's really cool is that it'll tell you also if your plan was a success or if it failed. As you notice here, it'll tell you observation succeeded. If it fails, if for whatever reason it didn't capture the object and it couldn't find it, for whatever reason, now it will tell you observation failed. It will tell you that it didn't get any images. But when it does work fine, you're going to be able to view the picture right away, which is great. Not only that, you can AI denoise on the spot. That's just awesome. Wow. That, we can compare the image to the old one like this, denoise like this. We can now download it. And let's just see exactly how many minutes it really got, right? There it is. Okay, so this is why I said you don't want to plan your shooting session for 10 minutes, because look, it really only got 2 minutes. So, but this looks amazing for 2 minutes. This looks really incredible. Wow. And we can keep playing with this, right? Wow. There they are. So this is incredible because I just did the AI denoise and it looks good, right? But when you still play with it some more and do some adjustment with the lighting there, it looks even better. And that's, I mean, it almost seems like I stacked this one even longer, but it's the same image. So this is actually impressive. I do feel like the Seestar is just getting better and better over time as they continue pushing out these updates. I mean, this is really amazing. Wow. Now, if I go to my album, there they are. Absolutely. Yep. They're right there. But this is just impressive. Okay. So it's still ongoing with the plan. Okay, so it's on my next object, which is Horsehead Nebula. Okay, so it looks like it's moving on to the next object. Okay, let's see how this one came out. And with the little AI denoise, there we have it. Okay, so it's doing Rosette Nebula right now. Now it's about to finish. I want to see what happens. It's about to finish the full session of the planned shooting. There it is, doing it on its own. It captured the image. Okay. Okay. That was all on its own. I didn't press anything. Observation succeeded 3 times. All objects. Like I mentioned, if it's not able to grab your image, it'll tell you failed. Okay. We can denoise this. There we have it. And now if I click on execute, okay, this is for the test number 2 that I hadn't done earlier. It says ongoing, but it can't start it yet. It has to wait till the time. So it says to observe for both of the next objects. So pretty cool. Let me know what you think about this feature and if you've already tried it. I'm here the following day after the planned scheduled shooting that was just done. And I realized that I forgot to mention something, and it's a word of caution regarding that once these scheduled sessions are complete, once you're finished with that, keep in mind that the Seestar arm actually closes and it goes back to its home position. So just wanted to mention that because I know some people like to use external accessories on their Seestar. For instance, I like to use the dew shield and external light blocker. And if the Seestar just closes without you knowing, it could get jammed or it'll just pop off. So just something to keep in mind. I'm hoping that somehow there'll be some type of workaround to this that ZWO will figure out while we're doing these planned sessions so that we can still use our external accessories on the Seestar.